So, Dr. Scholz, we have a lot of new things coming out in the kind of landscape of prostate cancer, and it seems like a lot of new things are coming out all at once and compared to maybe even 10 years ago. So can you explain why we're seeing so much new development in the data?
I think we're reaping the investment in what the scientists call basic science. In other words, instead of looking to jump right to a cure, what they've done is invested a tremendous amount of money and time and energy in learning how cancer works, how the biochemistry of the cell works. And in the process of doing that, they've discovered how cancer is different than a normal cell. If you think of it, an analogy like a computer, it's like a glitch in the cell. And once they find those glitches, they've also developed ways to create patches, they call them for computers, but for the treatment of cancer, it's usually a medication. And that medication acts as a bridge where the glitch is and helps restore the cancer cell to a more normal state, which is, you know, not growing furiously out of control the way cancer does.
So some of the new treatments that are coming out, or we're looking, you know, hoping will come out soon, is really in the immunotherapy section. So how do you see Keytruda playing out in the trials? Is it going well?
So Keytruda is a medicine that they talk about it taking the brakes off the immune system. Our immune systems are so powerful, they have to be heavily controlled. When they get out of control, you get multiple sclerosis, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, a lot of sometimes even deadly conditions where the immune system is running unchecked. In fact, some of the concerns about the COVID virus is that the virus is turning the immune system on so vigorously that it makes the patient ill, or you could even kill someone. So there's a balance that's happening in our immune systems all the time, and Keytruda and other medicines like Opdivo and Yervoy work by taking the brakes off the immune system, which is certainly a worthy risk in someone that might be dying of cancer. And Keytruda itself is in phase 3 trials for prostate cancer right now, and we don't know the answer yet. We've used it in phase 2 trials. It has activity. It's well tolerated. It's particularly famous because President Carter had an advanced melanoma in his brain several years ago, and now he's still alive. He got an amazing response to Keytruda. It's infused every 3 weeks, and I would say that these medicines like Keytruda, Opdivo, and Yervoy are being used, they're very much in their infancy. We don't know how to optimize them. We give the medicine and hope for the best. In the future, we're going to be able to select patients who are going to be more likely to benefit, and I'm sure we'll figure out ways to enhance the immune effect.
What percentage of men would you say are responding to Keytruda?
Well, it depends on the type of people you treat. If people have less advanced cancer, their immune systems are more intact, and the immune resistance of the cancer is not as profound. The roots aren't as deep. So when you talk about people with very advanced cancers, their immune systems are weak and have cancer all over their body, the response rates are not that great. You know, 10, 15, 20% perhaps of people will get some benefit. When you look at earlier stage men, maybe as many as 50% are getting a benefit, as signaled by a decline in PSA after starting the treatment.
You mentioned side effects. What type of side effect profile does it have, and is there any concerns with it interacting with other medications?
Not so much interactions with other medicines, but the immune system is, operates in all areas of our body. So overimmune activity for your skin is a rash problem. Overimmune activity in your lung is an asthma problem. Overimmune activity in your intestine is a diarrhea problem. The overactive immune system can create problems in any organ system, and it is unpredictable. So it really challenges the skill of the doctors that are giving these medicines to be very vigilant, to check thyroid levels, check adrenal function, because if the immune system knocks out the adrenal glands, then people become deficient in cortisol, which is dangerous, or if it knocks out the pituitary gland or the thyroid gland. So intense monitoring is always a component when we're using these medicines.
So that's a lot of different side effects that could happen. Do you know, based on the trial data, how many patients this would happen to out of the percentage of patients on the trial?
Probably about 20% of patients that take these medicines will run into something that will need either a dose reduction or discontinuation or some sort of maybe some cortisone to kind of calm the immune system down. As we've mentioned before, Joanne Wheathouse at UCLA and others are working on ways to test our immune systems and through looking at genetics and determine who's likely to get side effects. And some of the preliminary work that we've seen in our office indicates that this is effective. They can identify people who are unlikely to get immune side effects. And in the limited number of patients that we've treated with Keytruda, who were predicted to have a low incidence of side effects, indeed have really not had any side effects. So we've been testing people in advance of these medicines and withholding Keytruda in those that are likely to have side effects and administering it in those that are at low risk for side effects.
That type of testing is obviously really incredible for a patient who's looking to take Keytruda and would be able to know ahead of time. When can we see this testing be more widespread across the U.S.?
Well, like any research process, it takes anywhere from 6 to 24, sometimes even 2-3 years before the trials are completed, the FDA approval is happening. And I think that's why we're having this talk today, is that there are ways for savvy patients to access medicines that are not approved. For example, we're all excited about the recent approval of PSMA PET scans, but people have been getting PSMA PET scans for 2 or 3 years on clinical trials and benefiting greatly. So this is why I think in our modern era, being sensitive and having an understanding of what's going on behind the scenes can really make a big difference for some patients.
So you mentioned Opdivo and Yervoy. How do you see those different from Keytruda, or do you use them in combination?
Opdivo is more similar to Keytruda. Yervoy is a little different, although they all work by taking the brakes off the immune system. And Bristol-Myers makes Opdivo, Yervoy, and they've been used in combination a lot with notable benefit in prostate cancer, and at least in preliminary trials. My sense is that the combination of Opdivo, Yervoy is more likely to be associated with side effects and perhaps more likely to be associated with a good response. But that's limited exposure, and these things are early. Ongoing research is in process, and we'll know more as time goes on. But it's nice to know that there is activity associated with these medicines for prostate cancer patients.
Hi, everyone. This is my new puppy. We haven't named him yet, but I'm sure you'll hear his name soon. We're super excited about him, and he's going to be around for our outros, if he lets me do them. So anyway, if you can visit our website, pcri.org, that'd be great. We have a ton of information out there for you, and don't forget to subscribe, right? Subscribe to our YouTube videos. That's him saying yes. And we come out with new prostate cancer videos every week. Have a great time.